Everybody, it's Roger, and driving the 2021 Tesla Model Y Standard Range. Been driving it now for a little over a month. Got over 1,500 miles on it, and just like it more every day. The only upgrades on this car are basically the full self-driving package and the tow package, which I haven't opened up the tow hitch yet. I'm not sure exactly how that works. I'm gonna do a little research before I pop that open. I just wanna make sure that once I open it up, I can plug it back up. And I've heard that it's kinda hard to get that plastic piece back in there. So it's not my car, so I don't wanna mess it up. But I do want to see what's under that plastic rear shield and see what kind of insert that you need to get in order to tow something. I'm hoping it's like a kind of like a Reese Hitch receiver, to where I can use my work truck hitches to plug in there with a pin. So I'm not sure. Hoping that you don't have to take it out every time. I can get something. I have most of my trailers have military style hitches, so maybe I can keep one in the back, and if I ever need to tow something, I can. I think this car should tow 3,500 pounds, which is probably one of my trailers empty. I'm not sure about the tongue weight. I have to look it up to see how much tongue weight it can pull, but I do have a small trailer that weighs probably about 800 or 900 pounds, and I have a small stump grinder that weighs about 1,500 pounds. So I'm thinking that would be a good fit if I'm out going doing some stump grinding or smaller activities that I'm not hauling more than 3,500 pounds. I can still use this to work, so I can stump grind and do estimates. But anyway, the only thing I've gotten so far, I've gotten this rubber little insert, and I've got the rubber floor mats. I had the windows tinted, and I got the trays, and also too, of course, the chargers and adapters. So I spent $20 on the shelving, the little inserts for the trays. It was $20. I spent $20 on the little rubber insert for the cup holders and the change holder. The floor mats, I got a cheaper set because it came with all the mats, even the frunk and the trunk. I think I spent about $130 on that. To tint the windows, basically I just had the front windshield super light tint and the side windows light tint. I think that was like $120. The chargers, I upgraded and got the CHAdeMO charger, which I can charge at any Nissan. That was the most expensive charger. I think it was $399. And I bought the upgraded Tesla charger adapter kit set for 220 outlets, and that was $199. I think that's about it. So maybe later on, seat covers, front and back, and I'm thinking about getting the top tinted, because it does get a little bit hot. But instead of getting the top tinted, I was thinking about doing a wrap, and they can do a wrap that's perforated on top, and then they can do a clear wrap over top. So I don't know if you guys have ever had a perforated wrap, but when the water gets in it, you can't see anything. It kind of fills in the holes and it's real blurry. So I think if I do the perforated wrap on top and then do the clear coat over top of it, I should still be able to see. And also too, that'll cut down like probably 95% of the solar heat and the light coming down inside the car. So it'll make the whole car darker, which will make the tint look darker, and it'll make the car cooler because it'll reflect more of the UV. There's also ceramic tint and stuff they use, but I'm not sure which way I'm going to go yet. I have to do some more research, but I will let you know either way. But just tinting the windshield and the two front windows after factory has made a huge difference, and I think it makes the car look a lot better as well. So basically, if you guys have a new Model Y and you don't want to spend a lot of money, but you want to, the money you do spend, you want to basically stretch it out, I think the first thing I would do would be tint the front two windows and the windshield. That would probably be the, if I can't do anything else, that's what I would do. The first or second thing I would do is get rubber floor mats, because that's going to protect your investment. I might even do that first. That's what I did. I got the rubber floor mats. I ordered them as soon as I could. They came in within a few days, maybe a week, and I installed them immediately. Because I didn't want anything to hit the carpet and ruin the carpet. And you want to get the rubber mats that basically conceal the whole entire carpet. You don't want any carpet showing if possible. And you want to get the kind of where if something spills, you can pick it up and dump it out. And also too, I can take these to car wash. I can pin them up on the wall and spray them off and just wipe them with a wet rag or a towel and put them back in the car. That's probably going to save you the most. Thinking about a dash mat to help protect the dash, but I'm not sure if I can, and how that works on a Tesla, because there's speakers and there's sensors. So I'll have to do some more research before I buy a dash mat, because I don't want to alter any type of sensors. But I usually get dash mats for every one of my cars, because it's the most important thing is to protect your investment and keep the sun from hitting the dash. The first thing is to tint, because once you tint windows, it protects the car. The ultraviolet is probably the worst thing on a car. So tint it, floor mats, and then of course charging. You want to get a set of adapters, so if you travel a lot, you want to be able to charge at the most spots available. So that's basically why I got the floor mats, the window tint, of course the little rubber gasket that goes inside the cup holders with a change holder, all the adapters, CHAdeMO adapter. Everything beyond this point is going to be like not really needed necessarily, but fine tuning. Like, I'm bald headed, heat hits the top of my head. The tint helped, but it's kind of hard to tint this humongous. And it's gonna be expensive. It'll probably be $100 just to, close to $100 just to tint that, because it's just really hard, and it's hard to get done right. And I have a really good guy that tints windows, and he kind of frowned. He didn't really want to do it, but he will do it. But it's gonna be expensive, and it's not something they want to do. But it can be done. But if I get it wrapped on the outside, it's gonna be a lot easier on the installers. And I think it's going to be a lot better. It'll be able to block a lot more of the heat. And I think I'm going to go that route instead, just because I think if you tint it, it's just hard to say. It's just hard to get someone to tint it. It's expensive. But if you get it wrapped, perforated wrapped, it's going to block, I think, more of the heat. And I think it'll look better too. I don't know. So I'm still kind of on the fence about that tin or wrap. If anybody has any experience with that, please let me know, because I'm on the fence on that. Other than that, I don't think maybe a wrap on the outside. I wanted to wrap the front of the, if I can't afford it, I'm just going to wrap the front and do a clear coat on the hood, the front bumper. But I have to get a estimate on that. If anybody knows what that costs, please let me know. If anybody's in Jacksonville, Florida, please let me know if there's anybody in the area that's good and reasonable doing clear coat wraps. So other than that, I love the car. Been driving it over 1500 miles. If there was anything I would change about the car, I think it would be, I guess the range, if I traveled more, I would probably get a little more range, but I haven't had a problem. I've been doing estimates. I've been driving over 100 to 150 miles a day and haven't had a problem with range. But I can see if I were to travel more than probably 500 miles, like I would say if you travel more than 500 miles regularly, I would upgrade and get a bigger, the bigger battery pack, which I think this has. It's just software limited. We might find out in the future that this has more range than it's letting us use. So that's a possibility. So we'll see if they let us use more of the battery, if it does have a bigger battery pack. Might upgrade the rims. The rims are okay. The hubcaps are okay. They're not really flashy, but if it were my car and I wanted a little bit more flashy, I would probably change the rims, get different rims and tires, and maybe get the upgrade or make it look like it had the spoiler, like a spoiler flash, more flashy, and the red calipers and nicer rims. I think that would probably set it off. And I think it would be cool too to have the Tesla emblems pulled off and just do a decal instead. It's gonna be a lot better when you're washing the car and stuff. It's not gonna catch on things. So I think that's it. The car is fast enough. It's 0 to 60 in like 5.3 seconds. I've never had a problem needing more acceleration. It's plenty. So far, I haven't had any problem with range. I haven't really went out took it on any trips yet. I like the interior. I might do the seat covers just to protect the seats. I think that's about it. I don't think I would change much more than that. So anyway, this is Roger with Roger's Reviews on the Tesla 2021 Model Y standard range with the tow package. So if you like this video, please crush the like button and subscribe, and I'll try to do a review first on the tow package, open that up and see how that works, and maybe do a 2 or 3 month or 6 month review. Or if I find something that annoys me or I really like that needs to be said, I will post it. All right, have a great day, and see you soon. Peace.